Boxing prodigy John Hayes is just an amateur, but he's gonna have a big career in the world of boxing.
I'm working on my rhythm, just keeping my hands flowing, working on my footwork, my head moving.
You're an amateur boxer, you're 6'4". Yep. What makes you so good as a fighter?
I think that I've been really trained to change my styles. Not just a brawler, but a boxer, working in and out. I've been trained to fight inside as well as outside. And my footwork, the 8-9 years of soccer, has really helped me out too. I played 2 years varsity soccer, varsity basketball, and varsity cross country.
So playing other sports really help you in boxing.
Yep, that's right.
And it's vice versa, because being great in boxing could help you in every other sport, because the endurance.
Exactly.
Tell me about that.
Exactly. Well, I know in basketball, you know, it's helped me where I can switch up my styles because my footwork, the way I drive, I got to put my weight into it and turn. So it's helped me really turn off my shots.
I've seen you, John, spar with some of the best professionals out there. Tell me about that. How's that going?
You know, it's a challenge, and I want to be pushed. And if you go against the best, you're going to be better. You know, it's going to push you to be better. If you dance with better fighters, then you're going to become better overall.
I've seen you and Yusuf Mack. He has a major fight. Who else have you sparred?
Edison Miranda.
No way. How was that?
It was good. It's almost more mental than it is physical.
You're kidding. He's one of the best fighters on the planet.
Yeah.
No, seriously.
It is. It's more mental than physical. Your physical presence will only take you so far. You have to mentally be able to sacrifice.
How old are you?
Put yourself out there. 21.
You sound like a wise old man. How good is Miranda?
He's amazing. He's helped me improve tremendously. Since I've been sparring Edison Miranda, my improvement has just skyrocketed.
Who else?
A few other guys, don't remember the names.
Can you hold your own with them?
Yeah, I do.
That's crazy, man. So when are you going to turn pro?
I'll be in June.
What can you tell me about your grandson, John?
I just bring him down here, let him work out, take him to tournaments and stuff.
How much does he love boxing?
Oh, I couldn't explain it.
More than anything, huh?
More than anything.
And what does he do in his tournaments? Tell me, for people who don't know.
Oh, I don't know. He does real good.
He dominates. He punishes people.
Yes.
How long have you been boxing?
3 years.
Really?
Yeah.
Hey, look at him. He looks like an innocent kid. He doesn't look like he's vicious.
Two sides to everything. Yeah. There's always two sides. You know, I've really struggled
to find
balance.
Two sides to the coin?
Exactly right. There's two sides. You have to find that balance. You can't be overly aggressive, and then you can't be too passive, but you have to find a balance in life.
Do people think you're Ricky Hatton?
2 points.
Why does he like the boxing? And the only thing that I can come up with is I used to box in the Marine Corps. And then I went into the martial arts.
Do you have a nickname yet?
Nope.
What would you want to be called?
Nope.
Bert Trueger, he's a boxing historian with the hat.
Yeah.
So if you got in the ring today with Bert Trueger, who would win?
He would.
What do you think? Can your grandfather fight?
Oh yeah, he can fight. You have no idea. 5 different black belts. He's boxed in and out of the Marine Corps. He just doesn't talk about it too much.
Wow.
He's not a bragger.
But most guys who fight are probably way shorter.
Yep.
They are. So you're like the Klitschko's of the amateurs right now?
I know. Middleweights.
So there you have it. Future boxing star John Hayes. In Van Nuys, I'm Elie Sekbak reporting.